Are you looking to get into Adobe Illustrator but have no clue where to start? Trust me, I've been there. I had such a struggle when I first started using Adobe Illustrator. I'm still learning today. However, I have put together these 10 little top tips for beginners when you start using Adobe Illustrator. So without further ado, let's get straight into the video. The first thing that I always recommend is to practice with the pen tool. The pen tool can be so daunting when you first give it a go. It seems to not be fluid. It seems to be a little bit confusing. Trust me, I've been there. However, I can assure you that it gets a lot better with practice. What I'd recommend is following tutorials on YouTube, having it a little play around with the tool itself and just seeing what you can create. I actually have created a video of my own showing you how I use the pen tool, so I will leave that in the clickable eye button and you can go and check that out after this video. But basically, once you've got the hang of the pen tool, you can create anything you want in Illustrator, so that is a must. You also need to make friends with the Pathfinder. So switching over to my laptop, as you can see, I have an array of random shapes on my screen, and I'm gonna quickly demonstrate for you how the Pathfinder works. So we have two shapes here, a square and a star, and I'm just gonna quickly put this star in another color so you can see. And you'll find the Pathfinder tool down here in this panel, so it's the two squares overlapping. If you can't see it, it's in Windows and down here, make sure that is ticked. So the Pathfinder allows you to cut out shapes, join shapes. Basically, Illustrator is lots of shapes put together to make a pretty picture, effectively. By doing this, you can drag over the star. And I don't know, I want to cut out this star from the square, so I'm going to highlight both shapes, and if I click this one, it'll take it away. And then another example, if I click like this and click this one on the left, it'll join them together, so it's one solid shape. And then yeah, you can just play around with it. So again, try the other ones. You can click this and it just leaves the overlap. You can kind of see where I'm going with this. It's worth some experimenting with to find how it'll be useful to you. However, I'm going to quickly show you how I would use it. So let's draw some circles. And then we need a rectangle. And then I'm going to just curve one corner of the rectangle. So now we have what looks like a cloud. However, it's made up from a bunch of different circles and a weird looking rectangle with a rounded corner. So in order to join these together, you just select them all and click this one on the left. And now that is one solid shape. It's not just a bunch of different elements. So that's the Pathfinder tool. I definitely recommend having a play around with that and seeing how it can work for you. Alongside the Pathfinder panel is also the Shape Builder tool. This is a tool I always forget about, but when I use it, it honestly helps so much. Here we have a very rubbish looking house. So this house, as hopefully you can see, in fact, let's change the color of this. We now have an orange house. This is made from a number of shapes. So we've got a triangle at the top, a rectangle for the chimney, and then obviously the windows and doors. So with the Shape Builder tool, you can select the parts of the shape that you want to join together effectively. Again, you can play around with it. There'll be loads of different ways that you can use it. So you can select all of the house. You okay? Why are you moving? Bye. I love it when my laptop glitches. Try again. So select all of the shapes, and then the Shape Builder tool is here. It's just two little circles and an arrow. Click on that. You can see that my cursor is sort of making a grid appear over the different elements. You can kind of see it better on the white ones. So basically, all you do is draw over the bits you want to join together. So I'm going to start up here. I want the chimney, I want the roof, I want the house, but I don't want the windows and the doors because I want them to be cut out. There we go. So now, as you can see, it's one solid shape. The windows and doors have been cut out. They aren't included now. And we have one solid shape that I can move around together without having to group and ungroup things. The next one high on my list, and one of the reasons I love using Illustrator, is the color panel tool. It's probably got a different name, but I don't know it, so we'll just call it that. So for me, my color tools are right at the top down here. I actually want the color guide tool this time. And in here, you'll be able to see that it is arranging a bunch of different shades for me to choose from. Oh, also, before we continue, if you are enjoying this video, please do click the subscribe button. It's a little red button. I'm sure you've seen it before. Clicking that will mean that you'll be the first to know when I upload new videos, and you're also joining my little Alice's Army family. It'd be great to have you. So yeah, please do click the subscribe button. Again, if you can't see the color guide in here, go into Windows and just click color guide and it will appear. So from here, you can select shades of the color you've got selected. So obviously right now we have this like burnt orange shade. And if you click the drop down, it will come up with a bunch of different recommended colors in the various color match options. So you can go for complementary colors, and then it will let you select the different swatches. So let's go with these circles down here. So let's say I want to color the circles in this color wave, and I have a ready-made color palette waiting for me right in Illustrator. Let's get rid of that outline. So there we go. As you can see, there's so many different options. You can have a play around with which ones suit your project, but this makes it so much easier because it's all in the same application. The next tool that actually always really daunted me, I have only recently really made the use of this tool and only really seen the capabilities of it. It is the clipping mask tool. So with the clipping mask, it allows you to sort of, like a cookie cutter effectively, cut out the only bit of pattern that you want to keep or the only elements you want to keep. That description probably makes zero sense. So here I have a vector illustration of these splashes. And as you can see, when I move my mouse over it, you can see the vectors actually go outside the artboard. So how do you do this? I hear you asking. Why am I in such a weird mood today? I apologize. So all this is a clipping mask. So I'm gonna go over into another document and quickly show you how it works. So I've just got three shapes in an artboard. It can be any pattern that you want, any shapes that you want. This is just a simple demonstration. So what I'm gonna do is just draw a circle, and all I want to do is sort of cookie cutter it out. I'm going to highlight everything. I'm going to click Object, Clipping Mask, and Make. There's also a shortcut. And by doing that, you can see that it's just left the circle part showing. However, when I hover over it, you can still see the squares in the background. This means that I can adjust where those squares are. I can adjust the pattern. I can do whatever I want to the squares themselves, but it still leaves the circle intact. Again, that'll make way much more sense if you just give it a go, have a play around with it, and don't be afraid to experiment. All right, the next thing is to get familiar with the keyboard shortcuts. I'm sure you all know copy and paste. I use a Mac, so mine is Command C for copy, Command V for paste, it's Shift C and Shift V for a Windows user. On Illustrator, there are actually so many different keyboard shortcuts that will speed up your creative process, making everything a lot quicker and smoother and less stressful, which I'm sure we all need. To find the shortcuts, all you need to do is hover over the different tools, and in the brackets, you'll be able to see the relevant shortcut alongside it. I like using the eyedropper tool to select a color from somewhere else. I also use V for the selection tool, A for the direct selection tool, and a bunch of different other things. P is for the pen tool. You kind of see where it's going. So there'll be a lot of shortcuts that eventually you'll pick up over time, but I do highly recommend picking a select, maybe three or four, and trying to use them and implement them within your work whilst you're designing on Illustrator. The next one for me, I feel like, is a really underrated tool, but it is in the majority of Adobe applications, so it can apply to a lot of different things. This is the Align tool. Again, I'll demonstrate, that's why I'm here. I've just whacked myself in the face. So the Align tool is down here. It has like a straight line and two rectangles in it. When you click on it, it's got a bunch of different options, which I'm sure look very confusing to begin with. Again, window and Align will bring that up if you can't already see it. So let's pretend we're drawing a little picket fence or a gate or something, or prison bars. I'm just gonna copy a bunch of these bars over, and there we go. So what I could do, I have my guides on, I could sit and sort of arrange all of these. As you can see, it sort of guesses the distance for me and what I want. However, the quicker way of doing this is to sort of guesstimate the size that you want, highlight them all. Firstly, this tool here will stack them all so they're all even on the top and bottom. So as you can see, this one in the middle isn't in line with the other ones. So if I click this tool, it'll jump them all together and align them. I'll just do that again so you can see. So as you can see, they're not all straight. So if I click this tool, it aligns them all horizontally. And then if I want this fence's poles to be even, what a weird demonstration, all I need to do is click this one and then it will distribute everything evenly. So it kind of looks at the one at the end and the one at the beginning and spreads everything out in the middle. So I'll click that. And there you go, it has created an even space in the middle of each pole. This next one is for when you're kind of getting the hang of things and you want to spice things up. The work you're doing is quite cool, but it doesn't look very polished and you feel like it could look better. I recommend using highlights and shadows to bring out your work and give it that professional edge. So here is something that I created earlier. It's just a girl. I think originally it was going to be me. It was going to be my icon for something. I didn't end up using it in the end, but as you can see, it's quite nice. It's got some cool shapes and colours in it. She's very symmetrical. However, when designing it, I recognised that it needed something else. And all I did was add some shadows to it. So to make it stand out, I added the shadow around this side. I've added some highlights to her glasses and her hair, her lips. Anything where the light would naturally hit, I've added the highlights. And then the same with the shadow. So anything that would be in shadow, so like the back of her hair, the rims of the sunglasses, the inside of her lips. And although the one on the left does look pretty cool, I'm still quite happy with that. I think the one on the right looks a little bit more professional. It looks like something you'd see on maybe a website. And I think it just adds that little bit of pop and makes it look a little bit cooler. So they are the majority of the main things I'd recommend if you are starting out on Illustrator. The penultimate tip is to just observe and learn. The fact that you've clicked on this video shows that you're willing to learn. So I recommend having a look on YouTube for tutorials. There's actually a really cool website as well called Skillshare, where professionals teach you how to do various things. They have courses on so many different topics. I am working with Skillshare on other videos, just not this one, but I will leave a link in the description because I have a 2-month free trial for you guys. So if you want to go and try Skillshare for free for 2 months, just click the link. It'll cost you nothing. And yeah. And then my final tip, which I'm sure you've been told many a times, is to just practice. I like to say practice makes progress. Practice never really makes perfect because no one ever is really 100% happy with the things they do. There's always room for improvement. However, if you keep practicing the skills that you've got, revisiting old designs and maybe redesigning them, see how you've sort of progressed over a period of time and you'll be able to see the improvement that you've made over time. So yeah, that's it. I hope this video was helpful. If I've missed anything off or if you have any tips of your own for any budding illustrator artists, let me know down in the comments below. I'd love to start a conversation with you guys. Thank you so much for watching the video. As always, thank you so much for supporting me. Don't forget to press that subscribe button so you can see future videos from little old me, and I'll see you soon for the next one. Bye.